If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to GATE Electrical Circuit Series. This is lecture 5 and today I have taken 5 questions, question number 21, 22, 23 and 25. Okay then, let's try to solve it. This type of this star network and then some questions is given to you. Okay. So the first one is the resistance between A and B with terminal C is open. So if I take C open, this terminal is open, what is the resistance between this and this? If it is out, this is open means nothing is going here, no current is flowing here. So if I go to this path, I will directly come to this path. This is my closed path. So the total resistance will be equal to Ra plus Rb. That means Ra plus Rb is given as 6. Similarly, if I take B open, if I take A open, then between B and C. So with C open and between B and C. So Rb plus Rc is equal to, this is 11 volt. If I take, similarly A is open, so between B and C only BC will come. If B is open, if this is open, no current is coming through this, then if my current, if the path of the current will be this, then that means Ra plus Rc is equal to 9. So three unknown, three equation, I think you can easily solve it. Find Rb here, 6 minus Ra, place here. So you can place everything here. Rb, if you calculate, it is 6 minus Ra. From here you can calculate Rc, 9 minus Ra. You put everything here and you will find the answer. Finally, after solving it, you will find the answer as Ra equal to Rb equal to Rc. Ra equal to 2, Rb equal to 4 and then Rc equal to 7. That is your option B. If you are not solving, if you are seeing from option, then also it will satisfy. Ra plus Rb should be 6. So 4 plus 2, 6, 4 plus 2, 6. So this is satisfying everywhere. The next frequency, Rb plus Rc, that should be 11. 5 plus 2, 11, 7. So it will not be the answer. So 4 plus 7, 11, this can be, but let me check other. 3 plus 4, it is 7. So it cannot be answer. So this can be answer. So you can check last one, A plus C, it should be 9, 4 plus 5, 9. So option A is giving answer, 7 plus 2 is 9. So A was already gone, only B or D is left, so only B will be the answer. You can check with the options also, which one is satisfied, if you don't want to solve. Two incandescent bulb lamp of 60 and 40 watt are connected in series with the main, then the bulb together consumes this one. So when they have given 40 watt, if you see a bulb, in incandescent bulbs, that is that old yellow bulbs, if you see those bulbs, if it is given 40 watt, then some voltage is also given there. So it is 40 watt at a particular voltage. So if I take the valve 1, so the voltage rating is fixed for both this one. For the same voltage, this is one is giving 40 watt, one is giving 60 watt. So what will be the resistance of the first one? That is V square by R, that is the voltage rating by 40 equal to V square by 60. So you got both the resistance. Okay. Now if you connect this one, valve 1 and valve 2, valve 1 and valve 2, across a source. Source means again with same voltage V, the rating of that. Because both are now connected in series, so total resistance will be R1 plus R2. What will be the total power? V square by R. R means R1 plus R2. So if you take R1 plus R2, this is R1 plus R2. So if you do this one, you will find 24 watt. So total power of these two is 24 watt. So together they consume 100 is not answer. Together they consume 50 is not answer. Together they consume only 24 watt. Now which one is grow brighter? So now if you see brighter, both one will have carry same current. So current will be same, but the voltage across these will be different to voltage across. This will be V1, this will be V2. So which voltage will be more? Because I is same, the one which is having higher resistance will have higher voltage across. If it is higher voltage, then it will give higher power. Our brightness will be more, power will be more, power output will be more. Okay. So which one is having high resistance? If you see this one, this one you are dividing by 40, which is lower than 60. So obviously R1 is greater. So R1 is greater than R2. As because your R1 is greater than R2, your V1 will be greater than V2 because I is same in both the case. So because V1 is greater than same, that means 40 watt will grow brighter. It will look brighter because this power will be more here. So that is option D is the correct. 23, they have asked a group of mutual inductance, this satisfies. You know M is equal to K root L1 L2, this one you know. Now what is the value K? K is the coefficient of coupling. So what can be the highest value of K? Coefficient of coupling means how much they are coupled to each other. If they are very close to each other, then all the flux between these two are interacting with. So if they are very close to each other, then the flux passing through this will also linking through this. If they are very close to each other. If they are not close, then some of the flux will go outside, they will not link. The flux, if all the flux links, that means it is totally coupled. Totally coupled means K equal to 1. If K equal to 1, that means they are perfectly coupled. That means all the flux that is going through L1 will also going through L2, both the coils. If coil 1, one flux is going, the same total 100% flux will pass through coil 2. There will be perfectly coupled there each other. No flux will be missing. It can be something that some of the flux is not going, some of the flux is coming here. It can be that some of the flux is going. If it is K is 1, that means all flux is going between these two. So this is known as perfect coupling. But perfect coupling never happens in practical. So K always remains between 0 to 1. 0 means no couple, no, not a single flux line will pass common between these two. So obviously K will be between 0 to 1, it will be some fraction. That means K, M can be maximum of root L1 L2. If K equal to 1, then it is maximum. If it is fraction 0.5, then K will be half of, M will be half of that one. So the value of M will be less than this or equal to. Equal to will be K equal to, if my K equal to 1, then this is equal to 1. If my K equal to 0.5, then this M is equal to half of this, that's it, it is small. So you can fill it, because K is fraction, that means M is lesser than this. You are not multiplying. K is fraction means ultimately you are taking some portion of this one, not full. K is 0.5 means you are taking half, that is you are dividing actually by 2. So that's why M becomes less. Someone can think, I am multiplying, why it is not increasing? If you multiply by 0.1, it will not increase. 100 into 0.1 is what? 10. It is not increasing. So if it is integer, then it should have increased. 24. In the circuit shown in figure, it is found that the input voltage Vi and the current I are in phase. So how volt V and I are in phase? If they say this line, V and I in phase. What is the meaning of this one? The meaning is total reactance is zero. Total reactance is zero. X total is zero. Circuit is purely resistive. So the coupling coefficient is this much. M is the mutual inductance between the coil. What is the dot polarity and what should be the dot and what is the coupling coefficient K? Okay. So my induct capacitive reactance is J12. So that should be equal to inductive reactance. The sum of these two should be equal to zero, or you can say this equal to this. That also, that's also okay. Or this plus this should be equal to zero. So ultimately, this is minus. If you go that side, that is will be plus. So I'm writing this capacitive, this reactance, capacitive reactance should be equal to inductive reactance. This one. So what will be this one? This will be summation of two inductors J8 plus J8. And because J8 is already 16, there can be plus minus. I'm writing plus or minus 2M. 2M. M means K root L1 L2. This is math. So these two is given 16. So if I add more, if I take plus, then it will be J. J will obviously come, because from here itself J will come. No need to worry. So if I add more, so it will be more than 12. So plus will not be the answer. So plus cannot be. It cannot be plus. So it should be minus. So when it should be minus? You know from dot convention when it is minus? When it will be minus? Because here it is entering. This dot is entering. So because minus you need, so here it should leave. The current should leave. So I will put dot here. So current will leave the inductor through this dot. Here current is entering the inductor through this dot. So both will be reverse. If they both enter, then positive. If both leave, then positive. If one enter, one leave, then it is negative. So my dot is in Q. That is okay. Dot is in Q. Then what should be the value of K? So it is 12J. 2 into K into. And this is L1, L2. Both are same. That is 8. I think you can calculate from here. 16K is equal to 4 or K equal to 0.25. So this is your answer. That is your option C. K is 0.25 and dotted. So 25th, they have given current direction 2 ampere, 1 ampere, and one current is also flowing through this. They have given the direction of this current. So all this current are given. VC is given. This voltage is given. No current, this current, this current. So what will be the current? If they are asking my VL, they are asking VL and no current direction is given. This is plus. So always the load convention is that you think that current is entering through this. This is my load, that's why it is entering. So it is entering through plus term. So this is the condition of VL. Always load convention is followed. Because here already they have given C, it is this direction. So I am not considering here the current. If I have to consider current, they have not given, then I could have considered this way. This is the load convention to considering the current from plus to minus. But they have already given, it is from this direction, so I have not calculated. So what will be the, if I take KCL, all are incoming. So all current will pass through this, this will also come through this, this will also come through this. So your IL will be summation of all current, 2 plus 1, 3, plus this current. What is this current? Capacitor IC. What is IC? IC is C dV dt is equal to I. I is given direct C dV dt. So this is differentiation. So I is equal to C dV dt. So that's okay. C is given 1 and differentiation of this one. What is the differentiation of this one? 4 sine 2t. 4 sine 2t, 4 cos 2t and then again 2. So 8 cos 2t. So it is 3 plus 8 cos 2t. So what is VL? VL is equal to L di dt. So what is your L? L is 2 Henry and differentiation of this one, di dt. Differentiation of this one is minus 16 sine 2t. So that is minus 32 sine 2t. In fact, they are not asking that polarity also. Okay then. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.